Hi everyone, this is Dipendu Gonai. So continuing from the previous lecture, today's topic is conversion and this is our lecture 4. In this lecture, we will learn how to convert an ordinary differential equation to an integral equation and similarly how to convert an integral equation to an ordinary differential equation. Also, we will see some examples regarding this conversion. So before that, let me tell you, if you are new to my channel, then please subscribe our channel and share it with your friends as much as possible. And if you see that my videos and my contents are beneficial for you, then please stay with us. So let's start today's theory. So we have two types of ordinary differential equation with respect to the boundary points. First one is initial value problem and second one is boundary value problem. And I know you are all familiar with these two terms, that is initial value problem and boundary value problem. But let me tell you again, what is initial value problem? When an ordinary differential equation is to be solved under conditions involving dependent variable and its derivatives. In a differential equation, suppose this is dy dx, this y is called dependent variable and this x is called independent variable. So here given that when an ordinary differential equation is to be solved under conditions involving dependent variables and its derivatives at the same value of the independent variable, then the problem under considerations is said to be initial value problem. Suppose d2y dx2 plus lambda y equals to 0. This is a differential equation, ordinary differential equation, and this is second order differential equation. And the conditions are given, suppose y0 equals to 0 and y dashed 0 equals to some constant, suppose 1. Okay, here both the conditions are depending only one independent variable, that is 0. So this type of ordinary differential equation is called initial value problem. And what is boundary value problem? When an ordinary differential equation is to be solved under conditions involving dependent variable and its derivatives at two different values of independent variables, then problem under considerations is said to be boundary value problem. I am considering only the second order differential equation. So what is boundary value problem? Suppose d2y dx2 plus lambda y equals to 0. This is a second order differential equation and the conditions are, suppose y0 equals to 0 and yl equals to some constant k. Here the two boundaries are 0 and l and the conditions are depending on two independent variables. So this type of problems is called boundary value problem. Now we have to see how to convert an initial value problem to an integral equation, or from an integral equation, how we can get an initial value problem, and similarly for boundary value problem also. So first of all, from initial value problem to Volterra integral equation. Remember, initial value problem will always convert to Volterra integral equation. Okay, and similarly, a Volterra integral equation will always convert to an initial value problem. Now we will understand this process using this example. Here given, convert the differential equation y double dashed x minus 2x y dashed x minus 3yx equals to 0 with initial conditions. Here given, initial conditions y0 equals to 1 and y dashed 0 equals to 0. To Volterra integral equation of the second kind. Conversely, derive the original differential equation with initial conditions from the integral equation obtained. So in first part, what we have to do? In first part, we have to convert this differential equation into this Volterra integral equation. And in second part, we have to convert the Volterra integral equation which we are getting, we have to convert that equation into this differential equation. Okay, let's see. Here the given equation is y double dash x minus 2xy dash x minus 3yx equals to 0. And the two conditions are y0 equals to 1 and y dash 0 equals to 0. Now, as we have to get the integral equation, so we have to integrate this ordinary differential equation. So integrating, this will be integration 0 to x. We are integrating from 0 to x, and this is with respect to x. So integration 0 to x y double dash x dx equals to integration 0 to x 2x y dash x dx plus 3 into integration 0 to x yx dx. So this will be y dash x, and the limit will be 0 to x. And similarly, this is 2x y dash x. We will use the UV formula, integration UV dx. You know, this will be U integration V dx minus integration du dx into V dx whole dx. Okay, we are using this formula. So integration 0 to x 2x y dash dx, this will be 2x, this is our U, 2x into integration y dash x dx minus derivative of 2x, that will be 2, and integration of y dash x, this is yx, and whole integration, this is dx, and the integration limit is 0 to x. Okay, plus 3 integration 0 to x yx dx. Now this will be y dash x minus y dash 0, and this is 2x integration of y dash x equals to yx minus 2 integration yx dx. We don't know what is the integration of yx dx, so this will be as it is, 2 integration yx dx, and the limit is 0 to x plus 3 integration 0 to x yx dx. Now the value of y dash 0 is given, y dash 0 equals to 0. Now put this value here. So this will be y dash x equals to 2x yx minus 2 into integration 0 to x yx dx plus 3 into integration 0 to x yx dx. So simplifying this, we are getting y dash x equals to 2x yx plus integration 0 to x yx dx. Now here this is yx, but we have to get, this is y dash x, but we have to get yx. So again integrate, again integrating, we are getting, and the same integration limit will be 0 to x, and the integration will be with respect to x. Okay, so this will be integration 0 to x y dash x dx equals to integration 0 to x 2x yx dx plus, this is integration 0 to x yx dx. If we integrate this, this will be double integration yx dx. Okay, so integration of y dash x is yx, and the limit is 0 to x. So this will be, again we are using the UV formula. So this is u 2x, 2x integration yx dx minus derivative of 2x, that is 2, integration, there are double integration, so this will be integration yx dx. Okay, I am writing here again, integration 0 to x 2x yx dx. So this will be 2x integration 0 to x yx minus integration ddx of 2x, so this will be 2 integration yx dx whole dx. Okay, so we are getting 2x integration 0 to x yx dx, there will be 2x, minus 2 integration double integration yx dx. Okay, now we know that this double integration, we can write it as yx dx 2. Okay, so I am writing here this double integration as integration 0 to x yx dx 2. Okay, so this is yx minus y0 equals to 2x integration 0 to x yx dx minus 2 into integration 0 to x yx dx. This double integration is converted into this form plus integration 0 to x yx dx2. So we know y0 equals to 1. Here given y0 equals to 1. Now put this value. So y0 equals to 1. So yx minus 1 equals to 2x integration 0 to x yx dx minus integration 0 to x yx dx2. Here this is minus 2 and this is plus 1. So this will be minus integration 0 to x yx dx2. So simplifying this, we are getting yx equals to 1 plus 2x integration 0 to x. I am taking x is equals to t. So this will be yt dt. Okay. Minus integration 0 to x. We know how to convert a multiple integral, to a single integral. We know the formula integration, suppose a to x, y of x, y of t dt n. So this will be integration a to x, x minus t to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1 factorial into yt dt. This is the formula where using this formula we can convert a multiple integral to a single integral. Okay, so I am here using this formula. So this will be x minus t to the power n minus 1. Here n is equals to 2. So this will be x minus t by 1 factorial into yt dt. So this is x minus t yt dt. So finally we are getting yx equals to 1 plus integration 0 to x 2x yt dt. Here this integration is with respect to t. And if we take this x or this 2x under this integral sign, so this will, there will be no effect for this. Okay. And minus integration 0 to x, x minus t, yt dt. So finally, we are getting yx equals to 1 plus integration 0 to x, x minus t, yt dt. And this is our required Volterra integral equation. Okay. So from this second order differential equation, and this is initial value problem, we are getting this Volterra integral equation. And this is what? This is here. We know the general form gx yx equals to fx plus lambda integration a to x kxt yt dt. This is the general form, and here gx is equals to 1. Gx is equals to 1. And we know that when gx is equals to 1, that type of integral equation is called second kind. Okay, so this is a second kind Volterra integral equation. Okay, now in second part, here given conversely derive the original differential equation with the initial conditions from the initial equation obtained. We obtain this initial equation, this integral equation. From this integral equation, we have to get that initial value problem. So this is second part. This is our obtained integral equation. Now, to get the differential equation, we have to differentiate this integral equation. So differentiating, before that, let me tell you what is Leibniz differentiation method. Differentiation method. In last lecture, I have told you what is Leibniz differentiation method. Suppose integration a to x, let me take it gx to hx, okay, fxt dt. We have to integrate, we have to differentiate this integral with respect to x. So this will be integration gx to hx del f del x into dt, okay, plus replace this t with our upper limit. So this will be f x h x into dh by dx minus f x gx into dg dx. Okay, so this is the Leibniz differentiation rule or the Leibniz differentiation method. We will apply this formula to differentiate a integral part. So differentiate this integral equation, the derivative of yx will be y dash x minus equals to derivative of 1 equals to 0 and derivative of this part. So this will be, this is x plus t y t dt. Okay, now here gx equals to 0 and hx equals to x. Okay, so first of all we have to differentiate x plus t y t with respect to x. This is our x plus t y t. So this will be, if we del f del x equals to, this will be t y t, sorry, this will be only y t. Okay, so y t dt, and we have to replace t with hx. So this will be 2x and this will be yx. Replace t with x, so this will be 2x yx and dx by dx, that is 1. And in third term, here g is 0. So when we calculate dg dx, so this part will be 0. So this is 0. Okay, I am not writing here. So we are getting integration 0 to x yt dt plus 2x yx. Now we have to get the differential equation. So we have to remove this integral sign again. So again differentiating by similar process, this will be y double dash x equals to, here in this integral part, there are no term of x. I am differentiating with respect to x, but there is no term of x. So this will be derivative of this term will be 0. And in second term, this is fx hx. So replace t with x, so this will be yx. And dh dx, so dx by dx equals to 1 plus minus the third term will be 0 because lower limit is 0, plus derivative of 2x yx. So this will be 2x y dash x plus 2yx. Okay, now simplifying this, we are getting y double dash x minus 2x y dash x minus 3x equals to 0. And this is our given differential equation, y double dash x minus 2xyx minus 3yx equals to 0. Okay, now check, is that differential equation is satisfying our initial conditions. This is our initial equation. Now put x equals to 0. If we put x equals to 0, so y0 will be, this portion will be cancelled out. This is integration 0 to 0. So this portion will be cancelled out. So y0 equals to 1. Okay, and the second condition is y dash 0 equals to 0. If we put here 0, x equals to 0, so this portion will be cancelled out. And here x is equals to 0, so y dash 0 equals to 0. So we are seeing that from the integral equation, we are getting the same differential equation and the same initial conditions. Okay, so we have learned how to convert an initial value problem to a Volterra integral equation and the converse process from Volterra integral equation to initial value problem. Remember, initial value problem will always convert to Volterra integral equation and Volterra integral equation will always convert to initial value problem. Okay, so next, from this problem or from these examples, we are getting this statement. I have already told you that a linear differential equation of second order, that is d2y dx2 plus a1x dy dx plus a2xy equals to fx. So this is a linear differential equation of second order with initial conditions y0 equals to c0 and y dash 0 equals to c1. So this is our two initial conditions, can be transformed into non-homogeneous Volterra integral equation of second kind. I already have told you. So this statement, you have to remember it. So a linear differential equation of second order with initial conditions will be converted into non-homogeneous Volterra integral equation of second kind. If you wish to prove this statement, then you can easily prove this using the same method which I have shown in this example. Okay. Now, I will show you how to convert a boundary value problem to a freedom integral equation. And the similarly as before, a boundary value problem will always convert to a freedom integral equation, and a freedom integral equation will always convert to a boundary value problem. Okay. So here the question is, find the freedom integral equation of second kind corresponding to the boundary value problem d2y dx2 plus lambda y equals to 0. And the two boundary conditions are y0 equals to 0 and yl equals to 0. And the second part is given, also recover the boundary value problem from the integral equation you obtain. Okay. So the problem is same as before. First of all, we have to convert this boundary value problem to an integral equation, and the same process from an integral equation to this boundary value problem. Okay. Let's see the solution. Here given d2y dx2 plus lambda y equals to 0, and the two conditions are y0 equals to 0 and yl equals to 0. The two boundary points are 0 and l. Okay. So we have to get the integral equation, freedom integral equation. So first of all, integrate this boundary value problem or this differential equation. So integrating with respect to x, and the limit is from 0 to x. So this will be integration 0 to x y double dash x dx equals to minus lambda integration 0 to x y x dx. Integration of y double dash x equals to y dash x, and the limit is as it is 0 to x, and this will be minus lambda integration 0 to x y x dx. So we are getting y dash x minus y dash 0 equals to minus lambda integration 0 to x y x dx. Okay. Now y dash 0. Y dash 0 is a fixed value, but we don't know what is that value. So for this reason, we are letting y dash 0 equals to, let's some constant c. Okay. So y dash x minus c equals to minus lambda integration 0 to x y x dx. We have to get an integral equation. Okay. But there is a differentiate part. So again, integrating, we are getting integration 0 to x y dash x dx minus integration of c with respect to x. So this will be cx minus lambda integration 0 to x y x dx 2. Because if we integrate this portion, this will be double integrable. So this will be integration 0 to x y x dx 2. Integrating this, we are getting yx minus y0 minus cx equals to minus lambda integration 0 to x, and by the same formula, I am repeating, integration yt dtn, and the limit is a to x equals to integration a to x x minus t yt x minus t to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1 factorial yt dt. This is the formula where, using this formula, we can convert a multiple integral to a single integral. Okay. So integration 0 to x yx dx 2, if we convert it into a single integral, so this will be minus lambda integration 0 to x x minus t to the power n minus 1, and here n is equals to 2, so this will be x minus t by 1 factorial into yt dt. Okay. So yx and y0, the value of y0 is 0. Okay. So this will be 0. So yx minus cx equals to minus lambda integration 0 to x minus t yt dt. So we are getting yx equals to cx minus lambda integration 0 to x x minus t yt dt. Okay. Now the value of c, we don't know the value of c. We have to find out this value. We have two boundary points. One point is 0 and another point is l. Now put x is equals to l. So this will be yl equals to cl minus lambda integration 0 to l l minus t yt dt. So here c is equals to lambda by l integration 0 to l l minus t yt dt. So this is the value of c. Okay, now put this value of c in this equation. So this will be yx equals to lambda x by l integration 0 to l l minus t yt dt minus lambda integration 0 to x x minus t yt dt. Okay, now this integration is with respect to t, and if we take x by l under this integral sign, there will be no effect. So I am taking x by l under this integral sign. So lambda integration 0 to l x into l minus t by l yt dt minus, this is as it is, lambda integration 0 to x x minus yt x minus t yt dt. Okay, now here this is lambda and here another lambda. So I am taking lambda out of this bracket. Okay, and this integral part, integration 0 to l x into l minus t yt dt by l. Okay, I am separating this into two parts, integration 0 to x and integration x to l, and this is as it is, minus integration 0 to x x minus t yt dt. Now this part is integration 0 to x, and here this is integration 0 to x. So I am taking these two parts together. So integration 0 to x x into l minus t by l minus x minus t yt dt. Okay, plus the remaining part, integration x to l x into l minus t by l yt dt. So simplifying this, this will be xl minus xt, and this will be minus xl minus minus plus, this will be lt. So this xl and this xl cancelled out. So this is minus xt plus lt. So this will be l minus x into t by l plus yt dt, and this is as it is. So from here we are getting yx equals to lambda integration 0 to x this portion plus x to l this portion. So in general we can write it yx equals to lambda integration 0 to l k x t yt dt, where k is in this boundary 0 to l, k is equals to l minus x into t by l. Okay, and in this region x to l, the kxt is x into l minus t by l. And you have to remember that here the variable is t. So t will be variable. T varies in 0 to x, and here t varies in x to l. Okay, so here we have learned how to convert a boundary value problem to a Fredholm integral equation. And the second part, you have to go from last part to the first part. Okay, so you can solve it from how to convert an integral equation to a boundary value problem. Okay, so this is the syllabus what we have covered in our lecture. The linear integral equation of the first and second kind, we have covered it in our first lecture. Solution with separable kernels, we have learned there are four types of kernels. Okay, characteristic numbers and eigenfunctions, we have learned it in the previous lecture, that is lecture 3, and resolvent kernel, we also learned it in lecture 2. So all the syllabus are completed, but in next lecture, that is lecture 5, in next lecture we will learn that how to find out that how many solutions will be there in an integral equation. Suppose you are given an integral equation, and the question is that find out how there will be no solutions or unique solutions or infinitely many solutions. So for this we have a simple method, we will discuss it in our lecture 5, next lecture. So if you like today's video, then please share with your friends and subscribe our channel and stay with us. Thank you.